How is it to be married to a president? A lot of young people ask me that question, that being a first lady is really being married to a politician who's very powerful, but it's not your power, it's his. It's much more glamorous looking than what it is in real life. It's a challenge.
So what's your favorite social media platform?
So the only social media platform I'm on is on Twitter. I love Twitter. Because it really lets me be myself. So I've got one civilized and first lady account, which really just posts nice pictures and we did this and today we met who, and it's very orderly. And then I've got my own private account where I'm a little bit more free to share my views, and the people I engage the most are young people. I don't mind a young person disagreeing with me, but I want them to convince me why they are right. There's opportunities and there's also some threats. So we've got very high youth unemployment. So the private sector isn't absorbing as many young people into employment as it should, but that's also an opportunity for young people to become entrepreneurs. So I think that young people mustn't be demoralized.
Now, what have you put in place to support them?
So from my perspective, we run what's called the One Economy Foundation, and we've started a number of youth focused programs, including what we call the Be Free movement. And what Be Free is about is really we engage young people and we want them to be free of whatever holds them back. So we're not even talking entrepreneurship with them. We're just talking basic life skills. Basically, we want to be a movement that walks alongside young people and enables them to make the right decisions.
You are an advocate for the UNAIDS campaign, yes, focusing on young girls and young women.
Yes.
Why that particular cause and what's your involvement?
Now, it's the UNAIDS Start Free, Stay Free campaign. And the reason for my involvement is that it doesn't make sense for countries like Namibia to spend so much money in ensuring that mothers don't pass HIV onto their babies. So we've managed to reduce our maternal transmission rate to 4% by the year 2020. We're looking at 0%, where no mother passes HIV on to her baby. But what's the point of this huge investment of making sure that babies aren't infected with HIV, but then they go and get infected with HIV when they become adolescents? So the idea is to have them start free of HIV, but also stay free of HIV. I think the best advice for young people, and I know that your viewers are mostly between the age of 11 and 17, their focus must be on staying clear of decisions that will have a long-term impact on their lives, and make sure that the kind of actions that you undertake, that you protect yourself from consequences that will impact your ability to succeed in life.